Definitely. And a tethered up axe is also just as scary as a tethered up Huskar, the way you can run people down. Luckily,
Five.
Went
Nice,
bottle is
Grim.
not going to get filled up, so that's quite big. Wisp now can't heal his teammate so much.
Yeah, it's gonna be a bit awkward here, and he'll just take the meantime to
Oh,
kind of
top
head
lane!
Forward.
The cost is dead! He underestimated the caustic finale. It
First
can go so fast!
Strikes
He walked into
the.
That. And in a matchup, you know, Mikasa, we already know he's not a huge offlane player, and in that kind of matchup, we don't play very often. It'll catch you by surprise.
Well, it's Mikasa's. Oh, they're going on Poppy, body blocking him.
He's
going
to go all the way around the corner. ZYF with one more second for Lucid Beam. Not going to be necessary. They will get that Poppy kill, and they even things right back up. He was probably Q clicking after the call duration and just hit that Q button too many times. But here he'll have a second chance. Disruption, the arrow will connect. ZYF is there with a lucid
Care for the spins.
Highly Die helps him out with some overcharge. Envy steps in, gets the armor bonus, but is going to be forced to retreat, not going to be able to make it away. They got the lucid beam, and they want a follow-up kill for Highly Die. Can they knock him down with a nuke? It's not going to be necessary. They get him with a right click, and VGR pull up and ahead.
Eternal Envy, believing, but doesn't work.
It is Secret's bottom lane, which is their weaker lane, you know, pairing along with this. Bulba continues to really stride. Why has casually walked by and spotted out, so this will not go unnoticed.
He just wants to hang around when they kill it.
Actually, TG moves in.
Hold the dust. There you got him.
Back, and they get the dust. Get over here, you little son of a gun. He does manage to creep down a ward as he dies. Maybe.
Can they get Bulba?
They're hoping for it here.
Four-man
Thrawn
rotation.
Is coming.
Everyone is here.
Oh, yeah. They catch him with disruption now.
Run, Bulba.
He's good. He's dead. The arrow's going to fly. It will connect. They got Pilot Ido show up, but the Ravage comes out. And Mikasa says, no, sir.
Yeah.
That didn't happen. It takes them both down.
That tether was
on the offensive, but now that Dyer's opportunity is gone.
Oh, he walked into
reset.
Center.
He's dead. And they popped the dust. He's in the corner with nowhere to go. Valiantly tries to go for the TP, but Puppy says that's not happening.
Not even stunning.
Comes in from behind, takes off his head.
The sentry down.
But yeah, Moonlight Shadow. They're looking to make their move. Here's that sentry, and they're on top of it. Envy makes the call. It's only for DDC. That might not
that
be good enough. Here comes the follow-up Bulba, but the Ravage is there for Mikasa, and that could be good enough to shut them down. Envy eats a lot of the Eclipse. He's going to be going down, but Arteezy is here, and the Flaming Spears fly on out. He quickly makes work for Luna. Front flips forward. Disruption is going to be there to save Mikasa a bit. Arteezy will readjust. Goes for his new target. It's going to be no-no, and he goes down. Now Mikasa looks to in, but they can't do anything against this mighty Huskar Pylite Eye, able to keep him alive. Pylite Eye will end up going down, but not just bottom tier one. Then options for Roche become a lot easier.
What you mentioned there is a very big thing. They're next key timing. Oh, they're relocating.
Yeah, for FY. Little bounty hunter takedown, yeah.
The next big thing for VG Gaming is going to be when they have the Aghanim.
And they're hanging around this Roche pit now. They already have Sentry
oh,
by the
FY
pit down.
Again.
Yep, they move in, they pop the dust, and the call's there. They drag FY back into his near demise as he's going to be nuked down quite a bit. Puppy kits it with the shockwave there at the back end coming up from the Seder creep. And now
trying to take the fight as they have everything ready. Oh, they're reloading.
Reloading, back up above, we go for Mikasa, who has the Ravage ready to go! The Ravage and an Eclipse annihilates Pylite Eye. And Bulba's gonna be forced to retreat. It's a good amount of damage, but not gonna be good enough. They hit him on the track, he burrows to the low ground and makes it to Pump. He's gonna help him out with the heal, and then the stunned army comes out on the head of FY, who just got back, and now he gets dunked once again, Waga.
Yeah, it turns out to be a good trade in the Tide on top lane. Not care at all.
Split pushing Tide. He knows he doesn't have Ravage, so there's really not much he can offer at the moment, and I guess it's just going to be trying to stall Secret as much as possible. They're hitting their prime right now,
yeah.
Moving on forward, and VGR are just going to have to start reaching in their pockets.
This is the danger, though. The relocate is going to come in, and Bulba is just saving his stun.
And there's a dunk. And will the stun be there? Yes, it will. As Tide shrugs it off, but eventually the Fire Spears keep flying on through. Around, we'll see it coming.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, they're back at it. High ground teaching.
I mean, long wrap around from FY's bounty hunter way back in behind here, but Arteezy's already inside. Makes the commitment for Mikasa. There's going to be a defensive disruption right now, and the Moonlight Shadow will come out from Nono. But yeah, those backliners from Secret, man, they're waiting. I mean, I guess you know. Maybe FY will try to be there to stop a blink, but...
Oh, they don't want to continue for the... Oh, they saw. This little move by Wisp makes the Murana feel really safe.
Man.
And
Jesus,
it's not
like
the case.
I'm just farming creeps. Oh, what the hell?
Yeah.
We're all here. You're dead as hell. Secret showed up. They take out the Marauder with an Espy too. My God.
Oh, they pinged out with
Ancient Creeps to just slow the roll of this push in the mid lane as much as possible. Nono's looking past that while the rest of his team, as you can see up here in the top lane, make their move towards this tier two. Looks like they will be able to set up an arrow. Not going to be on the mark. Arteezy, long committed dive, puts it behind enemy lines. This might make it a little bit troublesome for Pi if Guy is too far from home, but they still haven't brought him down. Holds that first life. Move in. Mikasa shows up suddenly with a blink with a Ravage and tries to make it work for PG Gaming Reborn. The Eclipse is there in the back of a BKB Luna, but Puffy helps out with the heal power, and now the turnaround comes from Secret. Arteezy committing right back in, able to take down DDC. These disruption illusions poking at Arteezy a bit, but not nearly doing enough damage. He goes right back to work on the Rax. BG Gaming are going to be forced to buy out Nono, but it looks like a Rax will be taken here from the hands of Secret. Envy, deep dive in, spots out Ed, pulls him back, leads it for the stun, and then leads to an eventual dunk coming out from Envy. He's out for the count, no buyback. Or no, he does have a buyback. He actually might just be forced to use it here. This
I think
is going
so.
Fast.
There's just no one that can kill Arteezy right now, though. They need to make it work somehow with an arrow, and even still, the Chen can maybe send him back if they don't burst him quick enough. And there's Aegis. It's just too many troubles right now.
Nono jumps in with the Star Storm, but quickly gets stunned up. Is going to be leaping back and away here as they try to burst out Bulba. Bulba trying to force out. They're doing everything they can to ignore Arteezy. Go for the rest. Going to get Bulba down. They can't get him. The call's there. They pull back FY, but the Prince manages to weasel his way back out. But you can't forget Arteezy. He's there. He finally will drop, but that just brings him back. Rebirth, refreshed, and anew. Hoping Secret can close things out now. Arteezy all full life and full mana.
Yeah, the two big cores are dead. It's just supports, and supports did not do well against the Huskar at this stage.
Yeah, that's not a bold claim whatsoever. This is a mighty Huskar, and it doesn't look like VG Game Reborn are going to be able to do anything to stop him. Secret just moments away from closing out a Game 1 victory.
And we still see so many teams struggle with this. The Huskar pick, even though it's coming as a 4th or 5th pick, it's still catching them by surprise, it seems. Like, they don't have a lineup that's very prepared for a Huskar, I would say. There's no real hero that deals that much physical damage to a single target. Luna as well, but
Kasa moves in, but now quickly eats up a stun and a face full of burning spears. He'll go down. And this seems to be the final hurrah for VG Gaming Reborn. There isn't much of a final hurrah. It's already over, Waga. It's Secret who take game number one with a nice little Huskar game.
Dude, they kick off the Group B with a win. Of course, this is a two-game series. We're going to see if VGR can turn this around in the second game. Probably going to see a late-game Huskar ban in the second phase.
Yeah, that's where most teams feel like it's just best, because it makes it so tricky, doesn't it? In the first phase, if any team grabs a Wisp, a Dazzle, an Oracle, you're just forced to second phase ban Huskar.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you risk going against it. And then you see a situation like